Yankees lose yesterday 4-2. They have one extra base hit. That was the Chisholm home run in the bottom of the ninth inning.
Sure.
That went to the second deck. I think the first inning of each game was very telling and concerning. In game one, they had runners on second and third and nobody out, and they didn't score. In game two, they had runners on first and second, nobody out, and they didn't score. So they have not gotten the big base hit. And, you know, they keep saying, well, we hit into hard luck. It's part of baseball, man.
Yeah.
You know, there's no hard luck if you hit the ball over the wall. And the Yankees led the major leagues in home runs. And I know that there are not going to be as many home runs in the postseason as there are per game in the regular season, but there are statistics to prove that the teams that win score the majority of their runs via the home run. And the teams that homer more win the vast majority of the games in the playoffs. The way you win in the regular season is the same way you'll win in the postseason. And the Yankees have been shut down with their big bats. Aaron Judge has reached base three times in two games, which is not terrible. But in order for the Yankees to win, he has to slug.
Yeah.
Soto has to slug. And Stanton has to slug. And if they don't, it's not going to be an easy series to win. Because fundamentally, they're not the most fundamentally clean team. They don't run the bases that well. Defensively, sometimes they do things that make you scratch your head. So they have to play an ultra clean game in order to win. Game one, they got the breaks, and they won despite getting the big hit. Game two, they didn't get the breaks, and they scored two runs. Now, you've got yourself a series, and tomorrow, you've got Clark Schmidt going. And a lot of people had some doubts, why Schmidt, not Heel. You got Clark Schmidt going against Seth Lugo. And Don, Seth Lugo was money when he pitched against the Yankees at Yankee Stadium in September. That's going to be a tough game tomorrow night.
No, it's going to be a very tough game, as is the pitching in the postseason. These teams deserve to be here because they probably have good starting pitching and good bullpens. But, Michael, you can't have, you know, six singles going into the ninth inning and expect to be able to win.
Nope.
Now, if you get a doubles and triples, see, the Mets the other night in Milwaukee won that game one without hitting a home run, but they had a double. They had a bases-clearing triple from Winker. So if you don't have any runners in scoring position, you're not going to be able to get it done. They caught the break on the steal in game one, so Chisholm was in scoring position for Verdugo to get the hit. But you're not going to string four or five hits together to get a couple of runs. That's a tough rally in this day and age. So if Stan's going to go 1-for-4 with a single, Judge's going to go 1-for-3 with a single, Soto's going to go 0-for-3, you're probably not going to score too many runs. Yeah, you know, and this is a team with their with what they have at their disposal. You're not going to win too many games 2-1 because the other team's going to have their chance too. So that was a tough offensive performance, only one game, but you did hand over home field. That should be a crazy building in Kansas City tomorrow. You got yourself a series, man.
Now, Jazz Chisholm hits the home run, and you know, he's a very engaging interview. And the reason he's engaging is anything could spill out of his mouth.
Oh, I love that.
Now, he doesn't have that editing valve that a lot of the players do.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if you see some of the... You know what works hardest on the Yes Network? Meredith Marakovich trying to get anything out of these guys when she interviews them. Because they're all like Nuke LaLoosh. Process, you know, we'll hit the ball well. But Jazz Chisholm's not like that. And this is what he said.
Still feels the same that we're going to win it, you know. I don't feel like anybody feels any different, you know. We're going to go out there and do our thing still. We still don't feel like any team is better than us. Like you said, we had a lot of missed opportunities tonight, so they just got lucky.
Now, people are going crazy over that comment. Now, I think there's a possibility that if Matt Quatraro is smart, that's on the bulletin board tomorrow. We were lucky. You could also say the Yankees were lucky they're not down 0-2. And then that comment was met with such outcry that Aaron Boone walked it back today. He didn't really mean it that way. The question, you know, when he gets taught, well, he did mean it. He said lucky. Now, I think what he meant was the Yankees were unlucky because they had a lot of hard hit balls that didn't fall in.
Right.
So you gave the Royals a little bulletin board fodder. Let's see what the Royals did. Now, I have more of a problem with you losing 4-1 in the bottom of the ninth inning. You hit a home run. And then you go through that little dance in the Euro step and on plate. I'm of the belief when you're trailing, no matter when you're trailing, and you hit a home run, you don't do your whole dance. You don't do your whole act. But again, it's not something that drives me nuts.
Well, if it's earlier in the game, I'd feel a little different.
Oh, that's true. But and also 4-2, it's still a close game. one more guy gets on and you've got the tying run coming to the plate. So maybe that's what he's thinking.
But it felt more desperate. At that time, it's more desperate.
But nothing that he did drives me nuts. Nothing. Here's the problem with yesterday. The first three innings of the game, Carlos Rodon had no-hit stuff. First inning was about as good as he's looked as a Yankee, throwing 98, 99 miles an hour, painting the corner, hitting all four quadrants. But then the one thing that worries me about Rodon every now and then is when something goes wrong, it spins out of control. So he hangs a slider to Salvador Perez, hits it out, and then the rest of the inning just unraveled, and there's the ball game. That was the ball game right there. Now, remember, Yankee fans, that if the Yankees play a game five, your starter is, in fact, going to be Carlos Rodon. Yeah. I mean, that's not the way you want it yesterday to turn out.
No.
But, you know, I said the Yankees should win the series. They should go to the World Series. But the Royals by no means are a pushover. Their bullpen's been great. The Yankee bullpen has been unhittable. But the starters have put them in a little bit of a hole.
I don't know if you saw that Chisholm tweeted this out earlier today. If you don't believe you're going to win it, you won't. So you better speak this blank into existence and believe. Hashtag LFG.
And you know what? I buy that. But you can't say the other team was lucky. What he said before lucky was fine. If you don't believe in you, that's fine. But you can't say the other team's lucky because you handed them something.
But I do like the fact that, you know, at least it's not like it corporate gives a little passion. But you're gonna, you know, you got to win.
Definitely
games.
Not that.
But you know, you didn't get. You know, Cole wasn't great. Rodon wasn't great. So you want to get better out of the pitching. Bullpen though was very good.
Terrific.
You know, and that's what you're going to need. But the problem that has existed with this team for a decade has been what happens to the offense during the course of the postseason. You know, it's not really about the pitching. It's about, and you know, and if I four runs should not be enough to curse the Yankees. They have enough potential there offensively to have more than one run through eight innings and then a home run in a 4-1 game in the ninth inning. And they've got to produce better offensively. They were able to do it in game one. It bailed them out, but certainly didn't last night. And I will see what happens on the road.
Now, the big elephant in the room is Aaron Judge.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think he looks off balance at the plate. I think he's a little anxious. I think he's got happy feet. And when he swings and misses, he's like stumbling over home plate. Like all of his when he's right, he's so balanced. He swings, either he hits the ball, and if he misses it, he stays anchored in the right-handed batter's box. I've seen him tumble over into the left-handed batter's box. A little odd, and I think the Royals have pitched him very well. And even Judge admitted it yesterday. In game one, they went after him with fastballs. Yesterday, they went after him with changeup. So they've got his mind spinning a little bit, and the Royals are doing everything that I didn't think that any team should do, Don. They're going right at him. They're going right at Soto. They're not pitching around anybody. And they're saying, here, we think we could get you out. So far, they've done it. In order for the Yankees to get to the World Series, Aaron Judge has to slug. He does.
He does.
And I think he knows it.
And Soto, too. And Stanton, and there was the excuse when Stanton was out, hey, I don't have to pitch to those two guys. But they are being pitched to. Stanton is in the lineup, and he didn't really produce anything. This team is a power club. You rely on home runs. Let's see if they can do it.
I'm going to say something as damning as humanly possible, unfortunately, about Aaron Judge.
Mm-hmm.
He reminded me of me in his first at-bat.
That's not good.
He's one of the greatest players of all time, and I could barely make a varsity baseball team. So you don't want to hear the comp, but let me tell you why, Don. Because the reason I stunk at baseball, is that when I was nervous, I swung at everything. And Judge took a ball on the first pitch of his first at-bat yesterday and then swung it three straight pitches.
Mm-hmm.
He just seems absolutely desperate. And it's not often that a player, when they're in their sweet spot, they're swinging and missing at three straight pitches. There's something that is uncomfortable.
Well, the longer he goes without hitting a home run, he's going to put more pressure on himself.
And then he's going to be jumpier and swinging more.
Then it becomes a legitimate slump.
And not because of the Yankee history. I just think he wants to win. I mean, I get the impression this is a guy that will trade all of his numbers for a championship.
I agree. And not only that, though, Don, I do think there's a personal part of he hears the little conversation. Because, come on, he's a smart guy. He knows he's been dominant in the regular season. He knows he hasn't had a great playoff.
Right, and nobody's saying anything about Bobby Witt Jr., who's 0-9.
Right, because it's not a thing. It's not a storyline. It's his first time.
And also, he hit against the Orioles in the first series. Aaron, although he has 13 home runs in 46 games in his playoff career, he has not hit for average, and he's a great player who hits for average and hits for home runs. So he's got to get right. The Yankees are not making the World Series unless he gets right. Doesn't have to carry the team. They all have to hit.
Isn't this where Boone has to earn his money, though? Keep well, it, getting get your guy calm. No, well, you can't do that. But you can get your guy to calm down and work with him and try to get him in a place.
But what can you say? He's Aaron Judge.
He's one of the greatest players of all time.
I mean, the pressure is just, like, how do you talk to him? I mean, Judge is putting the pressure on himself. As you said, this is a guy that is produced in the regular season historically, but knows it doesn't mean as much if he doesn't do it in the postseason. Matter of fact, just adds more pressure because of who he is.
So someone's got to say.
I don't think it's the media. I don't think it's the fans. I think it's just himself knowing that he wants to win that ring so badly, and he's just putting an immense amount of pressure on himself. How do you tell him not to? Because there, of course, there's pressure. It's the New York Yankees. You're expected to win,
and the path is wide open for you right now. I mean, Michael, if they lose to the Royals,
there'll be issues.
Jobs are going to be on the line.
Oh, absolutely. You can't lose to the Royals.
In fact,
I am not dissing the Royals.
No.
But better than the Royals.
Well, but it's a wild card team that surprised making the playoffs. Now, if you lose in the League Championship Series to the Guardians, it's not going to look good, and the fans are all going to demand changes to be made. But I guess you can wrap your mind around the fact the Guardians were good all year. They won their division. You know, they were battling you for the best record in the American League. You lose to a 6-7 game series. I guess you can live with it. But in the wild card round, Peter, against the Royals, isn't the George Brett, you know, Dan Quisenberry Royals. No, this isn't even the Royals of 2015.
I will tell you the one thing about George Brett. I don't know how much of the game you guys watched. TBS showed George Brett more than the Royals would show George Brett on a Royals television broadcast.
It's crazy.
I mean, when you see stuff like that, you definitely understand why Yankee fans would get upset. I mean, it was like the George Brett inning.
But you know why they do that? Because who are you going to show on the Royals? No. I know Witt Jr. is a candidate for the MVP, but you know, the nation watching this, they know that it's mostly Yankees. The Royals don't have a huge fan base. They don't have a lot of superstar players outside of Witt, and that's still new. I'm sorry, Michael, a lot of people watching that game, George Brett's more recognizable than any Royal.
By the way, this is crazy, Michael. I believe there's so much pressure on the Yankees that if they don't beat the Royals, Robert Saleh will get fired.
Again.
Yeah.
Let's go to Henry in Colorado.